ChatGPT is only as good as the prompt that you put into the program. And in this video, I'm going to walk you through one of my favorite prompts for ChatGPT. I'm going to teach you how to use ChatGPT to assess complicated data sets, Excel spreadsheets, graphs, charts. Let's look at some examples here. And if you're into thriving with AI, if you want to crush it with AI, this is definitely the time to hit subscribe. Now let me go ahead and show you my screen. So once we get ChatGPT open, we're simply gonna click this little paperclip button here. If you don't see it, we're gonna upload it from computer. If you don't see it, you may have to upgrade to the latest version, but we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna find this supermarket sales data here. We're gonna go ahead and upload this, and we're gonna simply gonna ask ChatGPT to analyze the spreadsheet. Now, the more robust your prompt, the better your response is gonna be, but I just wanna show you how effective this is by just typing in, please analyze the spreadsheet. Now, this is a surefire way to look like a genius in front of your job, if you're preparing for any sort of presentation, if you wanna assess, again, any sorts of data. Let me put it this way. Have you ever looked at a graph or a piece of data and said, I don't know what I'm looking at here, I don't know what I should be looking at here? This is gonna really bring your analysis to the next level, because we can immediately see that what ChatGPT is doing is it's identifying all the important data in here, the order number, order date, customer name, shipping date, retail price, order quantity, et cetera, et cetera. And what's cool here is it even is gonna give us some example questions that we can kind of ask it, because now that it's processed the data, now we can actually go in and ask it for more information. And there's, I think, there's several thousand rows in here. This might take you a long time it might take you a while to analyze thousands and thousands of rows. Not with ChatGPT, and I think this is a big thing. So let's just go here and say, hey, show me some sales summary statistics. And again, what's cool about ChatGPT is it already is gonna know kind of what you want, and it's going to prompt you in general, okay? I have provided the summary statistics, et cetera, et cetera. And you know, let's say that I don't understand fully what this means. I could go in here and say something like, what assumptions can you make based on the data in the spreadsheet? And you know, again, this is where the more specific you are with the prompts, the better. So I might say, well, let's see what it gives us here, okay? So based on the provided summary statistics, at a quick glance at the data set, several assumptions and observations can be made. The retail prices of the products vary significantly, et cetera, et cetera. The minimum price is blank. Order quantity, the average order quantity is 2.4 and the standard deviation is about 1.33 units. Ooh. I mean, this is unbelievable. I can say like, if I want to drive more sales, what would you recommend based on this data? Or actually, instead of I want to drive more sales, I want to drive more profit. What would you recommend based on the data? And it's just going ahead and doing its thing. It's just giving me tons and tons of information. And you know, with respect to time, I just wanted to briefly show you one of the ways you can leverage this tool. If you have any spreadsheets with lots of data in it, lots of rows, you can easily upload it and start to ask questions and engage with ChatGPT, because the human brain is only able to process so many pieces of information at once. ChatGPT is processing thousands, hundreds of thousands, millions of data points almost instantly, categorizing them, putting them into data. And you can, again, it's just giving you, this is what I love. It's giving us example prompts, and it's just, is so, so helpful. I can even, this is kind of cool too. This is interesting. The product with the highest sales associates order number 1003, Michael Johnson, right? So this is kind of cool too here. What type of questions I'm preparing for a meeting. Okay, so what I'm saying here is I'm preparing for a meeting with my regional sales director. What type of data from this spreadsheet should I use to showcase our store's progress, potential, and also look good in front of him so I can be promoted? Let's see what ChatGPT says here. We're doing this in real time together. But let's face it, if we're looking at all this data, we want to look good in front of clients, prospects, regional sales directors, and go from there. So I think what's interesting here is it's being very specific on the stuff that I should be looking at, but it's not being specific on the numbers. Let me, actually, here it goes. It's not being as specific as possible. What this could be helpful for is I'm preparing is it helps me kind of go in and say, okay, let me find these pieces of data, the total sales revenue, sales growth, top selling products. But what, you know what I want to do here is I'm going to ask it to be more specific in regards to these numbers. Okay. And again, the reason I'm doing this is because I want to help you kind of think outside the box on how ChatGPT can really help improve your life. That's what this is about. And I'm on a mission to help 1 million people just like you completely thrive with AI. You can get, by the way, you can get this entire presentation if you go to aiupdate.ai. I have 52 weeks of different prompts, so you can each week practice a new prompt to become more and more effective. Go to aiupdate.ai to get that. But what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna say, can you be specific with data from our store regarding these points? And what I wanna do here is see if it can actually read all the data in the spreadsheet and give me this information. Now, one of the things I will just warn you about is you're gonna need to do due diligence. You're probably gonna wanna double check this work because AI, ChatGPT can sometimes get things wrong, but this is kind of like a really quick way of you to kind of get through this. So, I mean, you can just see how effective this is. It immediately breaks down monthly sales from the last couple months, quarterly sales, annual sales predictions, monthly sales growth, top selling products. I mean, like, this is gross. This is so, as someone who's been in spreadsheets for the last several decades, when I see how quickly ChatGPT is able to process all this data, it's unbelievable. It's absolutely, it's astounding. Let's look at another example that's not quite, well, let's look at another example. Come on, that's what we're here, right? Let's look at another example. So in this example, we're gonna look at a chart of a global energy consumption, okay? And we're gonna say, please analyze and summarize the data on this graph. Again, any graph, any chart, any data set. By the way, you can upload multiple data sets, multiple charts to give more and more context. So let's see what it says here. The graph titled Global Primary Energy Consumption, 1800 to 2015, depicts the global primary energy consumption by source over time, measured in terawatt hours. Here's an analysis. There's been a significant increase in global energy consumption from 1800 to 2015. Growth in energy consumption accelerates sharply from mid 20th century onwards. I mean, this is just ridiculous. What assumptions can we make from this chart? What predictions can we make from this chart? This is interesting. Key observations: the transition from traditional biofuels to fossil fuels marks a significant shift in energy consumption patterns. Fossil fuels dominate the energy mix, particularly from the mid 20th century onwards. There was a noticeable increase in the share of renewable energy sources in the early 21st century, indicating a shift towards more sustainable energy consumption. I mean, this is just ridiculous. Assumptions. The global demand for energy has been increasing steadily, especially since the mid 20th century. Dominance of fossil fuels, renewable energy transition. Nuclear energy has become a significant source of energy since the mid 20th century. Its growth indicates a pursuit of low carbon energy source. Listen, I could go on and on and on, but I just wanted to showcase this prompt and how powerful it can be in your professional development. If you're going through school, you should be using ChatGPT to assess charts, graphs, data set, take a picture on your phone, upload it to ChatGPT. What should I know about this so I can look smart in front of my teacher? What sort of questions should I be asking? What sort of assumptions can I make? What kind of predictions can I make based on this data? Look, this is a game changer. It's gonna completely transform your life. If you're into this, smash the like button, smash subscribe, and I've got 451 new videos that are gonna help you leverage prompts just like this to explode your world in the right direction. Thanks for subscribing. I'll catch you in the next video, all right? Peace.